Hey, it's Ben. We got bad news, as you probably already know. Wanted to get this video out earlier, but over the weekend, my computer and mic did not want to agree, and I recorded you guys a couple videos, and they had no audio, so I had to sort that out over a couple days, and I'm back with an update on the bad news that you already know. LoopX appears to have, well, not appears, I'm pretty, about 99.9% sure they exit scammed, as are the rest of us. Their website is unreachable, loopx.io. Their social media is gone. Their admins are gone from Telegram. They screwed everybody. They screwed me. They screwed a couple of guys on our team that got in the ICO, the rest of you that got in on their ICO and promotional lending. This hurts. Now, if you listen to the other videos that I put out, you know I always recommend that you put a little bit of money into these things if you choose to go in, and you spread it out amongst as many of these programs as possible, because this can happen at any time. We try to bring you the best based on our analysis of the landscape, but it doesn't always work out. And this was one of those scenarios where it did not work out. Now, let's see, on both my videos on LoopX, and again, we did not promote this during the ICO, but I'll just play a quick clip here. We'll be paid out weekly in Bitcoin. Now, this is a little bit fishy. You know, this could be a pre-promotion exit scam. So do what you're most comfortable with. I'm not gonna go crazy here. Pre-promotion exit scam. It's exactly what I said, and that's exactly what it turned out to be. And I went through analysis on a couple other videos on, you know, how this could be good for the platform and how they could be distinguishing themselves from all the other lending platforms out there. And unfortunately, that fell flat on its face. So yeah, it's especially sinister what they did here. Not only did they take everyone's money during the ICO, but they then went and sent out an email with this promotional lending saying that they're going to pay everyone in Bitcoin in the first 30 days, differentiating themselves, and use that as a tool to just screw everybody and take more money. So it's not like they just got scared during the ICO and the after the ICO with the Bitcoin drop. And of course, it's starting to come back a little bit here. They want the extra mile to take more coin from the rest of us. So there's some other people doing some analysis saying, oh no, things just didn't work out and they lost too much during the downturn with the coin, and maybe they didn't put it in USDT and Tether, and they just couldn't keep up. No. Not only could they not keep up, they knowingly went and did a promotion to steal from us. So, hey, this is a good lesson learned for all of us. You know, I've been scammed a couple times. I'm sure some of you guys have. This is a learning tool for all of us, for those of us that got taken with this and those of us that didn't. Only put in what you can afford to lose. Don't expect anything to pan out. Turn into $100 coin or something like that. Be reserved, have a plan, and understand that these things can exit scam at any moment. So, not sure what else we can say besides it sucks, it's unfortunate, but we're going to move on. And like I said in one of the other videos, we are not going to be bringing you many new ICOs as the space is saturated until we see something that really warrants our interest. And one of the things I wanted to see, we talked about this before as well, is a lending platform or an ICO that shows us that they have an actual trading bot. Now, Bitai is the closest thing we've seen to that, and we're reaching out to them right now to try and get some more information, but their new update is actually pretty promising. Statement on exit scams. We all just heard about LoopX. We all know about Devor and BitConnect, many others which have left many with the bitter taste of cryptocurrency industry as a whole. Many have asked if we intend to exit, and of course our answer is no. However, words are cheap. Yep, we would agree, especially when you're feeling down after this happens to you. Action is what everyone wants to see. So the real question is, what can Bitai do to prevent the same fate? So there's lots of information here. I'm going to pull out a couple tidbits, and you can pause as I'm scrolling through if you want to read yourself or log into Bitai's platform. You can see their update. They talk about AMI, their AI trading machine, and they've got some screenshots and a short video on their YouTube page of it supposedly operating. And they talk about some of the details, one of those being AMI has inbuilt safety. In other words, AMI's priority is to keep the original investment as intact safe as possible without running a loss. So you know, at least they're talking about some details. This is something nobody else talks about, and coming from stocks trading world, this is exactly what we do when we trade. You know, you have a lot of risk tolerance and risk tools built into our automatic trading systems that we've used. We've not used any AI base, but we've developed our own automatic trading systems. And this safety and risk profile is incredibly important. So it's good to see that at least they're talking about it. I haven't seen anyone else talk about it. Some professional traders will tell you sometimes the best trade is not to trade at all. Well, that's true. chances of loss exceed the chances of success. I mean, so they got lots of good words here. We'll see what they end up doing. This is particularly interesting down here. This is a big change for them. Since the ICO of the industry has changed dramatically and everyone must adapt, there's real fear in the industry, which is unjustified. Lending platforms, I don't know about unjustified, I think it's justified. Lending platforms have been given a terrible name. Yes, we know that, and with Bitcoin going down and the exit scamming, it's looking worse and worse for a lot of these things. And as we said previously, we need to change the way Bitai works. The entire platform and exchange needs rethinking to make sure Bitai is profitable. All right, here we go. These bullet points are the important things. The word lending will be dropped. All right, we've seen Thorncoin drop the word lending. They're calling it all staking now. Bitai is going to call it something else. You're not lenders, you are traders. Okay, well, not really. I'm not really a trader, but let's see what you're going to say here. If you want AMI to trade on your behalf, then you will create a drop with Bitai to send to the trading liquidity pool. Bitai will float against Bitcoin, Bitai BTC pair. We are dropping USD valuations. All right, so what does this really mean? This next bullet point clarifies that. Bitai sent to the TLP by members, so the liquidity trading pool, will be burned. So if I have 1,000 Bitai and I send 1,000 Bitai to their liquidity trading pool to be traded, they are saying that they will burn those coins, which is interesting. So you're not going to be getting paid back anything in Bitai. They're going to take part of that 8.6 million tokens that are held by the members. Whatever's lent to them will be gone. We'll also burn reserve coins at a ratio of 1-to-1. For example, there are approximately 8.6 million tokens held by members, which include purchase tokens and commissions. If all these tokens are sent to the TLP, they will be burned, and we will also burn another 8.6 million tokens, which were pre-mined and or which are currently being mined and staked. This will reduce BitAI circulation dramatically and help retain the value of BitAI token over time. It also makes BitAI a true utility token. If you do not know what burning a token can mean for you, then read this article here. Actually, I didn't click on this. We'll take a look at it together. So this is kind of interesting. This is, again, something we've never heard before. At least BitAI is not offering to take coin from us to implement this new and great system. They're just adapting with the market. What this means is if everyone lent all of their token, not lent, but I guess sent it to their trading liquidity pool, then their BitAI is saying that they would burn all those coins. So conceivably, the coin capacity could go down to zero if they really burnt them. At minimum, if more people want to lend or send to their trading liquidity pool, lending as we called it previously, they would have to buy from someone like you and I that got in during the ICO, and then they would have to lend it or send it to the trading pool, and then those coins are gone. They're not going to be paid out in some other coin, maybe they are going to be paid out in USD and have to buy more BitAI to convert it to Bitcoin. I'm not sure what's going to happen there, but it's not like it's going to be a cyclical nature of these coins being lent and coming back, being lent and coming back. The supply is going to drop dramatically if they really do what they're saying here. Anti-dumping measures will be implemented. This is not a freeze on accounts, but they are a measure to prevent dumping to protect the overall community. We believe this will ensure longevity and profitability. I don't know about longevity, guys. If you are burning coin, then the longevity of this project is as long as either all the coin is sent to you, to your liquidity pool, or I guess not. And if you're marketing yourselves as a liquidity pool, then I think a lot of it's going to be sent. So maybe this is a pseudo-consumable coin at that point. I don't know. This is kind of interesting. These measures also prepare us for a launch on external exchanges. Yep, this might be interesting. Their staking wallet's live, and they've got their Facebook back. So log in, read through this for yourself if you want to see the details. It's pretty interesting. You know, we talked before about the different business models for these different ICOs, right? One of them could be your exchange. And when you trade on an exchange, the exchange gets a fraction of those profits. That's one business model. Another business model is the actual coin itself, BitAI. And another business model would be this trading liquidity pool, which I drew an analogy to in the previous video as a kind of like a hedge fund, right? What does a hedge fund do? A hedge fund takes some of your money that you give them for a period of time. Typically, those hedge funds lock it up for a year or more, and they trade it, and you profit share in their trading strategy. Here, we're going to profit share in their trading liquidity pool. And I don't know. We'll see how BitAI really turns out. This could be legitimate. They're not asking for something new from us like LoopX was, and they continue to update us regularly with what looks like good news. So we're going to reach out to them and see if we can get more details on their trading bot. Let's see, why to burn cryptocurrencies. This is the article that was linked right down here somewhere. Yeah, there it is. Here's an article you can read on your own. Log in, click on the link. I'm not going to read it to you now, but we'll see if they end up really doing that. And yeah, that's something that's tough to actually verify. The only way they can burn a coin is to move it to a wallet that they then lose the keys to, right? So you, for example, you have your Exodus wallet. You could transfer Bitcoin to that Exodus wallet. You could lose the password. You could lose recovery phrases, the recovery key, and those Bitcoin aren't really gone. Those Bitcoin are just locked in that wallet, inaccessible by anyone to actually initiate a transfer. So the coin still exists. It's just non-accessible and nobody can get to it. There's no way to really verify whether or not they're doing that. We'll just have to trust them at their word. But hey, this is good news, and at least they're addressing the concern that a lot of us have. What LoopX did really sucks. We're going to stay tuned with the existing platforms, and until we see something really compelling, you probably won't see much in the way that we bring you. If something does come up, we'll explain why we're getting into it. Besides that, we'll keep some educational content coming, and we have some other projects that maybe we will talk about on this channel as well. Like, subscribe, catch you later.